Well, I think the key take-home messages from what I was trying to say this evening were that, first of all and foremost, is when you see a patient who has a keloid which is very large or very difficult to treat, the most important thing to ask them is what they want, because often you'll be surprised. You'll see this large keloid and you're thinking, well, gosh, I have to cut it off. I have to make it look normal. I have to get them back to normal. Maybe all they want is not to itch, not to hurt. Maybe they want to be able to turn their head from side to side. Maybe they just want to be able to wear earrings again. So it's entirely possible that you don't have to remove the whole thing to give them what it is that they most importantly want. So that's the first take-home message. The second is that, as we're well aware, if you cut off a keloid and then don't do anything following that, no intralesional steroids, no pressure dressings, no interferon, no radiation therapy, virtually a 100% guarantee on the body that it's going to return. On the earlobes, maybe about 50%. So anyone can cut off a keloid. The trick is making sure that it doesn't come back. And to do that, we need to throw every adjunctive therapy we have at the patient. What I've found over the years is that people tend to sit with one particular adjunctive therapy. They decide that one therapy is going to work for everyone, and one therapy doesn't work for everyone. And even if it does, we have a whole bunch of things out there. After we've done surgery, we have a golden opportunity to treat this patient. Most of those adjunctive therapies don't work as primary therapy. If you radiate a keloid, nothing happens, right? If you use interferon in an existing keloid, it doesn't get better. So you have this golden opportunity. You've just cut off a keloid. And my suggestion is throw everything at them all at once, anything that's appropriate for the patient. So perhaps intralesional steroids, interferon, radiation therapy, maybe pressure dressings if it happens to be on the earlobe, all at once. And I think you're going to have much better results.